So what we're trying to do with our new inspection methodology is make sure that the public, people who are using services, their carers and families, have got information that they know they can rely upon, because we will be getting underneath the skin of the services by asking 5 key questions: whether that service is safe, whether it's caring, whether it's effective, whether it's responsive to people's needs, and whether it's well led. And in doing that, we will be wanting to make sure that we're answering the questions that we know people ask of services when they're wanting to make decisions about where to go for care.
The new system for regulation is based on information, data, and inspection of GP surgeries. But at everything we do, the patient, the public are at the centre of everything. This is about making sure that patients experience really good care, whoever they are, wherever they are in England, whatever their background.
Over the past year, we've gained a lot of experience in our new approach to inspection of hospitals and mental health services. What we've been doing is having much larger teams taking part in these inspections. We gather as much information together as we can before we go to the hospital. We spend several days looking at the hospital, and at the end of it, what we do is to rate not only the hospital as a whole, but the individual services.
At the end of the day, we'll produce a report after we've inspected. And that report will demonstrate very clearly to you whether that care is outstanding, whether it's good, whether it requires improvement, or whether sadly it's inadequate.
Particularly in the last few months, we've been consulting with the public about how we should do that best. And I'm extremely grateful to everybody who has given us their opinions on this.
We have been developing our new approach to inspection and regulation of adult social care over the last year, and a tremendous number of people have been involved through various events that we've held, through our co-production groups, through the consultation, through, you know, sending me tweets and emails all about it. We've had all sorts of people being involved, and actually we couldn't have done it without them. It's really helped us to shape and design what we're doing, making sure that we're looking at the things that really matter to people, that actually influence them when they're making the decisions about what care they want to receive. And so I hope that things like, you know, how we ask the questions, you know, focusing on the experiences that people have, making sure that we've been quite clear about what's the difference between a good and an outstanding service. All of those things have been absolutely influenced by everybody, and I can't thank them enough. We wouldn't have been able to do it without you.
The response to our consultation has been great. We can't make this new system work without input from members of the public, from patients, but also from GPs and nurses. We've put all that together to mould the new system, the new regulation of GPs, and I'd just like to say thank you for your input. We'd like that input to continue. We've tried to respond to that feedback by moulding our new inspection regime, so that we can better address those concerns.
So we've learnt a lot about ratings over these past few months, and we're also publishing a handbook that sets out how we go about things and also sets out what the characteristics of good or outstanding and also of requires improvement and inadequate are. And I hope those will be useful and they reflect the views that we've been hearing over the past few months. To me, outstanding is something that is, it does stand out from the norm. It's something that other people may want to go and learn from. Good is about a service that I will be prepared to be looked after in myself or for a member of my family to be looked after.
Fundamentally, what we're trying to do is to think about the people who are using the services. And I want my inspectors to look at a service and think, would I be happy for my mum or somebody else I love and care for to use this service? The best place for people to go to find out more information is actually on our website. So that's the Care Quality Commission website, and you can put in your postcode and it will show you what are the local services that are available. You can go into that and see what our most recent reports are, what we've said about the service, what people who we spoke to when we went and visited the service said about it as well. And you'll be able to use that information and the ratings that will be included there too, to help you to make the decisions that you may need to make.